My name is Vince Lewis. I am the director of the Karate Center for Entrepreneurial Leadership, director of the Entrepreneurship Program here at UD. And today you're going to learn a little bit about flyer consulting and why it's important to understand how to work with all sorts of organizations, whether they're for-profit companies like Procter & Gamble or General Electric or a startup, or whether it's a non-for-profit. And I say non-for-profit, not-for-profit is really kind of misleading, because any person that runs a not-for-profit is going to tell you they still have to make sure they can pay the bills at the end of the year. You still have to generate enough money to make the thing work. You might raise money in a different way, you might have a different mission, you might have a different focus, but it's still there. Those core principles of operating an entity are still there, and sometimes they're much harder when you're doing something that you're passionate about and you're not doing it because you're going to make a buck off of it. So these guys are going to tell you about flyer consulting and the mission and what we focus on. I'm also the advisor for FC, so I have a strong passion for it, and I hope you kind of take away what our mission is here and what we're trying to do. So, Brandon,
thank you, Vince. Thank you, Vince. I appreciate that. Just before I get into flyer consulting, just because I'm old and I have a reputation for talking a lot and I'm about to graduate in a month, I do want to preface with something that I think is really important. So, Center Symposium, contrary to popular belief, the real point of why you guys are here today isn't just for extra credit in classes. The real reason why you guys are here today is to kind of just see what that thing was that your fellow classmate, your peer, or another student you know was doing, right? When they had to go leave the house to go work on a project for flyer consulting, when they had to go work on a research project for doing fruit flies and all these different things, right? Whenever people had to leave to go do stuff and they were working on something and they were really invested in something, this was that thing for me. With a month left to graduate, this is all I talk about. This is all I still do. I still do a little bit of academic work, right? But this is where my heart is. This is something really, really important to me. Vince kind of, I think, translated you guys very well why this makes such a serious difference for us. Usually under flyer consulting, it says the Marianist vision of the business school. I think this couldn't encapsulate more what we're gonna talk about to you guys today. We're gonna run through the history of what flyer consulting is, because I think it's important. We're still a novel organization, and what we're doing is so important that I think it's important to walk you through a little bit of our timeline. But aside from that, I'm gonna have these students up here, these consultants, and the next president of Flyer Consulting, Stephen Harvey, to kind of walk you guys through what the vision is, what the mission is, and what we're going to do, and how exciting it really is, okay? So this will be the agenda for today. I kind of just walked through it a little bit. I'm gonna do the past, because I'm old, and I'll let you guys know a little bit about where we started. Okay, so we're just getting into it first. Flyer consulting itself, you know, has come from so much, and I think it's important first, before we walk through the timeline of it, to have Pat kind of just tell you who we are today.
Like he said, I'm Pat Gasol, and thanks Vince for the great introduction. But so kind of building off of what both Vince and Brandon said, what is flyer consulting? So really at the heart of it, we're 22 hardworking students just like you guys, but what we put all of our time and effort into outside of the classroom is bettering nonprofits in the Dayton area and beyond. So we primarily work with nonprofits just around here, but we've worked with clients as far away as Colorado and trying to go even further if we can. But really the goal of the organization is to pay it forward. We're trying to do good work for the clients, do good work for the nonprofits so that they can in turn take what we've given them, improve their operations, run more efficiently, and help more people in the Dayton area that are in need. So whether that's somebody like PRG, Pink Ribbon Girls, who's helping cancer patients in the area, you know, driving them to and from treatment, whether it's United Way, who does just about everything for everybody all over the place. You know, we help anybody, anywhere, anytime with kind of anything. It could be a marketing project, could be building out an annual report for their donors. You know, really runs the gamut, and we're always willing to try new things. And so that intellectual curiosity is a piece that we'll touch on later in more detail, but that's a huge part of what FC is. But as Stephen or Brandon mentioned, the Marianist mission of the business school, everybody always hears the Marianist mission thrown around at UD, you know, being servant leaders, giving back to your community, taking what you learn in the classroom and applying that outside to better your world. And really FC is that, like the core of that. We take what we've learned in the classroom, all of your marketing classes, you know, your accounting classes, everything in your math classes, and we apply that in the real world to real world problems. And it's super exciting to be able to do that as undergrad students, because you really don't get that opportunity anywhere else. So with that being said, I'll hand it back to Brandon.
Yeah, before I move on to the next thing, I think Pat did a good job. I've always struggled and talked at length trying to define what flyer consulting is and what it really means to me. And I think everyone up here is just getting better at that and evolving with that. And as I leave, these people in this organization, these amazing people, are going to continue doing what we do, keep helping the community, and being that perfect intersection of taking what we learn in class and applying it, and taking service and volunteering. Okay, so with that, a little blast from the past. Okay, Flyer Consulting actually was founded in 2008 in the spring semester and first operational year in 2009. The founder, his name was Andy Blankenmeyer. Never got the privilege to meet him, but I'm very thankful he started this organization. It was a lot different then, just like a startup. Just like a startup on campus. What we did was we had probably about six students then, if I look like a historical record, about six students, people that wanted to make a difference, right? The stuff we just talked about, they wanted to see it happen in business school, because there wasn't really an opportunity then to engage the community and to use and apply what you're learning in the classroom. So about six students got together and said, let's make a difference. So they took a client on. They took a client on in the downtown area and worked with them for a semester. And then, boom, Flyer Consulting was born. For the next couple of years, they kind of kept this. People were falling in and out. There wasn't really an opportunity with those six students to step forward and say, let's take this organization to the next step. It was always kind of like six to eight students. The reason why, and I think we're going to get into this a little bit, is when you walk into the nonprofit, when you walk into their executive boardroom, and we're sitting down with the director, and we say, what can we help you with? What can we do for you? You know, I'm a 22-year-old student. One time I walked into the office, I was 19. I said, what can we do for you? What frustrates you? What can we help you with? And in the back of my mind, I was always thinking, they're going to just say, well, we could use some help with social media, you know, things that you guys know how to do. We got everything else. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. But that's not the truth. That's not what happened. The reality is that we walked in and they said, you guys are willing to help us? How much does it cost? It doesn't cost anything. We do this pro bono. We want to make a difference. We want to apply what we're learning. Okay? You guys don't cost anything. I promise. We don't cost anything. We don't charge anything. Okay, well, guess what? We have this whole closet worth of stuff for you. It's crazy. They wanted us to do so much. More than sometimes we think we can handle. And that made the six students, the eight students, the 10 students that were in Flyer Consulting for all those years, left them with a heavy burden of working for a lot, doing a lot of work for these nonprofits. And they weren't able to do the things that we're trying to do now with 22 students to make a difference and really make ourselves visible on campus and in the community. So Flyer Consulting's come a long way from that. Now we have 22 students. We are starting to really work on that visibility. You know, props to Vince, props to, you know, the dean, President Spina, people that are recognizing us, our great clients, people like that, and these consultants, this team, like people like that that I just really enjoy being around, that really promote each other, want to work together, creating the culture that you've always wanted in an organization to be a part of. We're trying to do that, we're doing it here, and it's been a long journey, and with that, I think it's good to transition into the present.
Yeah, so thank you, Brandon. I mean, Brandon has done so much for this organization. He's the sole senior right now. He's really been a catalyst for everything that we've seen the last couple of years growth-wise. You know, in the present, we're just doing even more. And moving forward to that, you know, you're seeing the logos change on the left there, right? It's kind of that transition from, you know, this organization that does a lot, not quite polished, to a really polished organization that has very set processes to get things done. Again, as Pat said, 22 students currently, a lot of them in this crowd. You probably recognize, you know, the faces if you look around. And we hired four new ones recently, freshmen. One up here actually talking about it. And I think that's, you know, really shows what we do, and that, you know, we're not exclusive, we're not trying to be a club, you know, that's exclusive and it's like, oh, four, you know, out of 60 people or something got in. What we're really trying to do is hire individuals that we know are impassioned just like we are to help the community, and that we can entrust them with, you know, the burden that is Flyer Consulting. It's a lot of work. And I would trust each and every one of those new individuals and everyone in the organization to come up here today and provide this, you know, this presentation. Because we all know it. And that's why we only hire four. That's why we hire a few people than most organizations. But we all know that, you know, they can do just as well as the president, you know, everything in the organization. So moving from that, I'm going to talk about the mission and values. So looking at this, you know, it's kind of what Brandon talks about. Like he gets on stage, and, you know, he gives 15, 20 minute presentations, a lot of talking. You know, I'll try to be a little more concise. But I'm getting a little more like him, I think. And that, you know, this organization, again, all the passion, all the things we do, we talk about it constantly, our mission, our vision, the values. And it took us a long time to codify that, actually put it into words and write it down. We probably sat in a room for 5 hours, and then the next day we sat in a room for 5 more hours and changed the entire thing to get just to this sort of, you know, stature where we are. So kind of just jump into the mission. Again, that day-to-day, that's what the mission is. It's what we do. It's what we get in the room, we get in our team, we put our heads down, we grind, and we work for it. And that is essentially to help better the community through giving that professional business advice to clients. You know, we're going out into the community and we're helping these clients with the reaction that, you know, they're going to go and take what we give them, you know, the help that we provide, and then serve others in the community. So I'm going to touch on a little later some of the tangible effects we've had, but that's really the mission of FC. You know, then moving to the vision. Vision is, you know, that overall, that overarching goal, right? What you see, you know, from when you're a freshman to getting out, like, we all have a different vision here. And that's why it's such a great organization, because every new individual that comes in, they have their own idea of how they can better Fire Consulting. And that vision, you know, has become that really impactful organization, the University of Dayton. The one that, again, lives out that Marianist mission, those values. And I think we're very successful at it, and we're only getting better. So, you know, living through that mission is very important for us. And that was, I'll tell you, that was a very long thing to write down. So from that, again, try to keep it quick here. Moving to the values. So the value chain, per se, you know, again, these are living documents, right? So this stuff was all created within the last 6 months. You know, that's like how Fire Consulting operates. You know, we're ever changing, and we're getting more steady in the way we do it, and the processes that we create are going to last even longer now as we grow. But the values are very important to us, and this is the kind of thing that this took forever, because we get up here and we talk about everything we do. We go over the clients, the projects, and the work, and it's all value-based. Like, why are we doing it? The why is the very bottom. This is that service and that passion. You know, so bringing it down from the left side, the challenge of this sort of pyramid, I'd say, you know, we're looking at accountability and intellectual curiosity. And really what that means to us is that we're all accountable to each other and to the organization that we work for. You know, we all have classes, we all have work, but at the end of the day, if we say we're going to do something for Fire Consulting, we get it done. This isn't homework, we go ask for an extension, or maybe we half-ass it. No, we get it done 110% every single time, because we're accountable. These organizations are real, they're businesses, and the members of the organization respect each other enough to get it done. Intellectual curiosity goes along with that, and that we all strive to be better. When you're a freshman, when you're a sophomore, even you come in here, you know, you're going through business classes, you know, maybe you're a finance major, learning, you know, finance 301, time value money, whatever it may be, marketing, you're learning all those things. But, you know, intellectual curiosity means that we want to jump outside our major. And that's what's huge in FC, is that I came in, you know, finance, a lot of technical skills, stuff like that. Well, I've been doing graphic work, I've been doing marketing. You know, you get outside of your comfort zone and you really learn a lot of great new things that you can take into the real world. And we're all, you know, curious in that way. A good example, you know, grant writing. We recently started writing grants for organizations. We didn't start that up, but maybe a couple of years back. None of us in the organization knew how to write a grant. But we took it on as a project, and we said, we'll get it done. Again, we're accountable for it, and we got it done. Through the help of a lot of great individuals in the university, Nikki Adams, a professor, does grant writing, so we went to her. You know, she gave us an hour-long presentation, wrote up a new PowerPoint for us, and helped us get it done. And then, you know, that just goes to show the university's passion as well, shown through Fire Consulting. So, you know, moving from that to the teamwork, we're a really tight-knit group. We sound very serious up here, and we are very serious in a lot of ways, because the work that we do is very important. But we never want to let it, you know, get in the way of our unity and us, you know, being a team and really working with each other. You know, we're not trying to force each other out or do better work and prove that, you know, we, you know, get up the ladder or something like that. We're a very flat organization that we work very strongly together in a unified manner. As well, we have that social aspect, right? We like to go hang out. Tonight, we're all going out to dinner together at Texas Roadhouse, you know, just because we can, because there's no classes or something, right? So we have those fun things that we do to keep us, you know, socially engaged, because we all like being together. And I think a great thing as well is, you know, a very diverse student body with, you know, the organization. And, like, not diversity in some general sense or some stereotypical sense, but just that we all come from a lot of different majors and backgrounds, and we don't normally hang out in the same friend groups. You know, we don't have the same cliques a lot of time. And so we break those barriers down as well. I think that's very important to, you know, getting those different perspectives to help the client even more. And the last piece, the dedication, right in the middle, you know, right at the core of Flyer Consulting. It's what we are. You know, the service aspect is why we're here. When we ask in an interview, why do you want to be part of FC? You know, it's not because, oh, I want to get this on my resume. You notice up here, there's nothing about that. There's nothing about your resume. There's nothing about getting a job later. We know that if you work hard at school, you work hard in this organization, you put forth your best effort, you're going to get any job you want. I think we've shown that with some of the organizations that, you know, we've worked with, and then some of the individuals in the organization who have gotten great internships, who've gotten great jobs out of it. They talk about it in interviews for hours. But the real reason why is the passion, the aspect, and service. You want to help. You want to go to this university because the Marianist values brought you here, and you want to expel them on these clients, you know, work with them, utilizing your business expertise, and getting that, you know, successful stories from them. That really drive you to work hard and again, probably put more effort into this than a lot of my classes, which may sound bad, but it's very true. Because again, that's the real world out there. What we do with them it's helping individuals that are impoverished, that have cancer. Like, it's crazy, right? That you can have that impact as a freshman or a sophomore in college, but you can't. And so, you know, all that leads up to really the success. And what that means to us is that we sort of display this purpose, that we actually achieve this purpose, which again is just to generally help, you know, our clients and each other succeed. So again, through doing everything that we do, through helping these organizations better themselves, better the community, then we're going to get those jobs. We're going to get that experience, and we're going to succeed as well.
I promise I won't talk for too long before I go to the next thing, but like, I have to add that Stephen has gotten so good at talking about these things, and it's a testament to everyone in Fire Consulting that we would have anyone up here speaking about this in front of you. And that's because after, you know, a year and a half of leading this organization, after, you know, being here for 3.5 years as a student, I've learned something. I learned something the hard way, the hardest way, of like trying to lead an organization with a very narrow vision of what I listened for, you know, 2-3 years. I watched and saw, and I was like, it's time. I'm president now. I know what to do, and I led them with what I thought was right. But after a year, I really realized that I was doing a lot of the stuff. It was good. We were doing well. We were making a lot of progress. I was so proud of us. But I learned something about myself, and I learned something about leading, and I learned that I needed to empower the people around me. And it's like, it's just words, right? I mean, I needed to empower the people around me. I needed to do it. We started bringing people that weren't in the exec team or team leads to our executive meetings, right? Call them whatever you want. But I started calling them brainstorming sessions. We had like Kevin Bradford's big ideas, right? These things were on our GCAL, right? They sound ridiculous. But those kind of actions made a serious difference. And we have never been running and moving faster than when I started doing that. And I'm extremely thankful for this team. And my last plug is, before I move on to clients, which is important, Pat likes when I say this. So as a senior, I know very straightforwardly what organizations are like, right? So the first organization you try to get into, you want to have friends, you want to have fun. That's why a lot of people get into fraternities early on, right? A social fraternity, or you want to meet new people, right? That's a good first reason. Many people do that. The second thing is you start saying, oh crap, people are getting internships. People are doing stuff while they're here. They're working on research, you know? They're in a professional fraternity. They're in FE, Hanley, Davis, Flyer Consulting. I need something that's going to have pertinence to my job application. So you get into it, so you have a resume. So you got those two checkboxes fulfilled. Those are pretty good two checkboxes. You get those done, you're feeling pretty good. You have something to tell mom about when she calls, right? Those are good. The third one's the most important. People always forget about that one. That's why people burn out of organizations, or they leave, or they just kind of do their thing. Everyone up here doesn't just do their thing. The third checkbox, and the most important one, is you just love being there. You want to be there. The culture, the people. The people are great. The job stuff's great. It's gonna help you move forward, but you just want to be there. We work on logos. We have 6-7 new logos that we're gonna have to choose from that Steve and I kept making for fun, like 2-3 hours a night for fun. Doing stuff like that, that's something I want. I'm a month away from graduation. I think today is the 5th, right? Is that the 5th of April? It's literally a month away. It's crazy, but we still do this. I'm still doing this, and I'm still relinquishing being president, or whatever that means, right? Because I still love doing this every day. Let's move forward, because I've been talking forever. Okay, two past clients. I want to just give you a quick story about this one for sure. Pink Ribbon Girls. So, I don't know if you guys are familiar with them at all. They're in Tip City. It's a little bit outside of the Dayton area, about 20, 25 minutes away, right? It's a stepping stone for us. We want to be able to serve a larger community, is what we talked about. Pink Ribbon Girls does a lot of different things for those who are struggling with breast cancer and cancer in general, with transportation for, you know, families that don't have the operations to be able to do that, don't have the capacity, the time, transportation, food, all these different things, right? Council, all these things. We wanted to pair off with them. They had an amazing executive director, Heather, with another team member named Gretchen. Awesome people. We met with them, we set the client project up, we were working with them, and I had this brilliant idea, one of my brilliant ideas, where I'm like, you know what? You know what would really make a difference? If we went out there and volunteered with them. You know, we do the client business work for them, but we gotta go see what's on the ground level. We gotta go participate in their service. Let's get down in there and do it, right? So they had an event at the UD Arena, and I'll try to be brief as possible about this, but at the UD Arena, we got there, we thought we'd be sitting at a table like one of the other donors, we'd just be a part of the event, and the ideas were that we would help clean up after. There was a lot of food there, a lot of different stuff going on, big fundraising event for them, their top donors, clean up after. Right as the event was about to start, like maybe 5-10 minutes before it, Gretchen and Heather pulled me and the team that was there into one of the back corridors where the team comes out, where the basketball team comes out. we were standing there, and Heather and Gretchen looked at me, and they said, "Brandon, I don't know how else to tell you this, but our service that comes and waiters and waitresses all the food here for this event, our paid staff is not coming. They're not coming." And I'm a student consultant, right? The student consulting firm. Who's here that's supposed to clean up after? And I'm like, oh, that's not good. That's not good. That's not good. And she looked at me, and she gave me some advice and said, "Can you guys do that for us?" And I know that I have absolutely no waitering and waitressing experience, right? I don't know what I'm doing. And I know most people in fire consulting don't. But there is one thing I knew. I knew that all of them would be willing to do it, give it a shot, give it our best, and we'll do whatever it takes, right? So I looked back at the team, and everyone's eyes were popping out of their head. They're like, "What? We have to do waitering and waitressing? How long? This is like a 3-hour event. Are you serious? There's like hundreds of people here in the UD arena." And I turned back around, looked at the executive director in the eye, and I said, "Yes, we will do it." So that whole night, we waited and waitressed the entire night for all these donors, right? I took the hit, took the biggest hit. I went up, there was like a plateau, like 20 staircases up. So I was drenched in sweat, we were in jeans and volunteering. But that's what it's all about. That's why we're so passionate, right? That's why people keep saying that this organization is electrifying, right? That nobody's sitting on their phones, or I don't have to tell you put your laptop away, you know, like that kind of stuff, right? You're just listening to what I'm talking about because it sounds emotional. We're invested. That's kind of stuff that we do. That makes a difference. With United Way, I have a very short story about that one. Great client, national client. A lot of people know United Way. We work with their Dayton chapter downtown. Their executive director, Tom Davis. This was one of my first opportunities to go as an executive member to a meeting. So at this meeting, Vince, actually, you were there with us, but I don't think you were next to me when this happened. After the meeting kind of was over and people were like awkwardly walking around, like shaking hands and congregating, figuring out something to say before we got out, Tom came up to me, and so I was the executive director of fire consulting at that time, and he came up to me and he shook my hand and he said, "Brandon, you guys got to do something to work." That's not the first time that's ever happened, right? I expect that, so I was like, "Yes, of course, Tom, we'll do good work." And as I went to pull away, he still had my hand, so I was like, what? And he like brought me back in and he said, "Brandon, you guys better do some good work for us. You gotta do some good work for us." And is that moment where I was like, okay, this service stuff's so important to us, this volunteerism is so important to us, but the work is really important. The quality is really important. This means a lot to these people. Why? Because it's not a classroom assignment. We don't just give it to them and we'll get a grade back. And then that's the end. We give it to them, and then they ask us all summer long, right, Mateo, to implement it, to do it. They want to do it. They want to use what we're doing. And that's the biggest difference that I think we make. And I'm going to pass it off from there.
Thank you, Brandon. So, you know, the last little bit here about, you know, the present and, like, what really made it click for me, you know, Flyer Consulting, what we do, like, how it helps. Where it became tangible, really, was this project I was about. So GDVLP, so the Greater Dayton Volunteer Lawyers Project. You know, it's a mouthful. What they are is they're a pro bono lawyer association. So, you know, we're pro bono consulting for pro bono lawyers. It's that pay it forward, right? And the specific thing, you know, they do a lot, but the specific thing that we helped them with was a program that they were running where they would have lawyers, so from the Dayton Bar, for free, again, all pro bono, drive out to elderly people's homes, you know, their residence or, you know, retirement home, whatever it may be, and they would write wills for them. You know, so a lot of people can't afford to pay a lawyer to write a will, but that's something super important if you think about it, right? You need a will. So they were providing the service. Initially, they started with being able to provide to 80% of the poverty line. So not even hitting the poverty line. And if you look at Dayton and what that really equates to, it's not a lot. So they weren't able to help nearly as many people as they wanted or that needed the service. So we came out to them, and they had an innovative idea to actually, instead of, you know, sending the lawyers themselves out, send someone else out with like an iPad, or, you know, some other kind of device, and then just have sort of Skype in so that they don't have to see, you know, they don't have to spend so much time driving and see more clients. Well, they needed money for that technology, so that's what we did for them. We wrote a grant, and I'm not going to read this to you, but essentially they had garnered about $10,000 for this grant where they were able to buy iPads. And it seems really simple, right? $10,000, not really that much money for a decent organization, but it took them from the 80% poverty line to now growing all the way up to 120%. And that's what really hit me, right? You're actually helping more people from what we did. You know, we sat down 5 hours, 6 hours, 7 hours, and we didn't know how to write a grant. We went to Nikki Adams, we asked resources at UD, and then we just kind of, we read a lot, and we figured it out, and then we tried a lot of times to write this. And eventually, we thought we got it right, and we turned it in, submitted it, and we just hoped that it worked out really well for them. And it did. They got money back. And because of that, they were able to help around 40% more individuals. That's crazy. And so that's when it really clicked for me, what FIRE Consulting really stands for, what it really is. You know, with that tangible effect that you can have, you know, being only a sophomore at that time, you know, I was just going through my classes. I was getting the organizations, doing things because it really bettered me. And this really flipped the switch on, you know, for what that meant, and that, you know, I can live it out, the Marion's mission as well, and I can help others through my work, you know, which then through all that, you know, empowerment, that work that I'm doing in order to help, you know, GDVLP, help PRG, help any of these organizations, you know, I gain a lot of skills. I can come up here and speak into it and all that. And I think that's really what FIRE Consulting stands for, is being able to create tangible effects for organizations so that they can turn around and create tangible effects for their clients.
Okay, so the future, I'm Molly, I'm a freshman here. So this first semester I came to Dayton and I was just looking around, like I wanted to find something, like a club, you know, that I was passionate about. So first semester I joined a few clubs and I really enjoy them, still involved in all of them. But like I hadn't found that passion yet, you know, the club that I was really, really interested in. So second semester, like new classes, everything's getting crazy and like still in all these clubs. And I was like, all right, good idea. Let's join another one and try to find the one I'm passionate about. So I was like looking around trying to find which one I was passionate about. And I got an email from an advisor saying FIRE Consulting, and not knowing really at all what FIRE Consulting is. I'm only in my second semester. Most freshmen don't know about it. So I got the email from it, and actually Pat came and talked to like my business class, so like I had heard a little about it, so I decided to go to this info session. And I go to this info session like expecting it to be a half an hour, like I'll learn a little bit, right, and I have a meeting after, like not knowing what I'm really going to get out of it. I go to this meeting and I stay there for an hour and a half. These people, like the FIRE Consulting team, I was so confused because they are so passionate about everything they're saying. And I was like, oh my God, I get to another meeting? Like, no, never went to that meeting because I ended up staying. And I was like, these people, they were so passionate. I like couldn't figure out, like, what are they so excited about? Like, why are they so into this? And so I was like, gotta figure out more, right? So I decided to literally apply that night for FIRE Consulting. And I went through the interview process and I got like the call that I got in. And I could not be more thankful now that I joined and I applied and that I went to that info session. Because FIRE Consulting now to me, like I'm going through this 7-week training process, which Mateo and Eric have worked so hard on, and it has been so good for us. Like me and three other freshmen were hired this semester, and we have learned so much more than, yes, I'm using like business calc and econ and everything I'm learning in classes, but like you're actually applying it through FIRE Consulting. I don't even know how to describe it. Like we're going through one-on-ones where we're getting to meet every new member. Like all the new members have to go and talk to every FIRE Consulting, and it's not like we have to go and talk. It's like you plan a half an hour meeting, and I ended up talking to Mateo for an hour and a half. Like it was like I actually have to go to class now. Like, I don't want to leave, but I actually have to go to class. Like sorry, like it's, you want to hang out with these people. They're such nice people. They're so caring about what they're doing and stuff. And so like FIRE Consulting, to put it into other words, it taught me what a 990 form. 990 form is a tax exempt form that nonprofits fill out every year. Had no idea what that was before I came into this organization. I called my dad the other day and I was like, yeah, at one of our training sessions, we learned how to do 990s. And he was like, Molly, what are you talking about? Like, how do you know what a 990 is? And I was like, oh, like FIRE Consulting. He was just like so astonished that I actually knew like what it was. And because you don't learn that in classes. Like, I don't know. Other freshmen, you know what a 990, like it's great, like all the things, like we're learning Excel like way more in depth and we're just learning so many new things that like I don't learn in business calc and I don't learn in econ. So through that, it's also taught me like hands-on experience. Like through this training, I'm also learning, like I've learned how to improve my LinkedIn profile, and I've learned how to just like network with other people and really get involved and talk to like alumni and just go to other events. And FIRE Consulting, like it kind of might sound crazy to you guys, but like I think I want to be a consultant now because I love already, I've only been in this for 2 months, but like I love what I'm doing here. We're doing this training and I'm learning so much, and they're all just good people that want to help nonprofit organizations. Like what sounds like better, like helping people in need of help. Like I don't know, it sounds like something that I want to do, and it sounds like something I could literally see myself doing for the rest of the life. Rest of my life, and these people have really made me like realize that. But and overall like flag consulting, we're helping with like nonprofits in Dayton for the future. I could literally see us like, I could see us doing like the rest of the US, and honestly I think it would be pretty cool if we could do some international, like go study abroad, like maybe help out, I don't know, I think that'd be really cool. But like these people, they really help you to strive to do your best. You know that they're always going to give their best, and I don't want to disappoint any one of these, not my other three interns that are working with me or any of the upperclassmen. I'm scared to disappoint them because they work so hard, and you know that they're working hard, so you know that you have to work hard. So in all, like Fire Consulting's future, it's a caring group of people that I hope to strive and see keep moving forward and keep doing what they're doing, and also hopefully go maybe more in the U.S. and like study abroad and all that.
Yeah, since you know this was supposed to be an hour long, and I do really like talking, and you guys all really wanted to be here. I will just say one last thing that I think is really important. Molly said just then that like she doesn't want to disappoint us, right? She doesn't want to disappoint us. She can't. I really don't think she can. I don't think she can. And I would just start pointing this laser pointer at all the people that are in Flower Consulting that are here right now. You know? But there's no point in literally me going. You got the glass with the glasses reflection. You got the glass with reflection. But there's no really reason why I should use it, because it's a testament to each and every one of them. I've never been in something, and I don't think I ever will be in again, something where there's 22, and that's just an arbitrary number, but 22 people where every single one of them, I would be happy to switch places with them right now. And let them come up here and talk to you. Let them work on the project. Let them be the team lead, you know? Molly, Justin, TJ, Morgan, the freshman we just hired, them too. They've been here for 2 months. It's incredible. She talks about FC better than I do. Better than I do. And it's a testament to the work and that each person has done individually on projects, the clients we work for, the advisors we've had, the opportunities we've gone after, the people we chose to try to speak in front of, right? The clients that we've called up, cold called, partnerships we try to create, all these things. And I'm thankful. This is my one thing that I will always remember at UD that I worked on, and I want these people to be recognized for what they do, and that's why we're trying to take every opportunity, take every advantage we can to move forward and get these people recognized for the great work that they're doing, okay? I will open it for questions.
We have one more plug, actually, for especially interested individuals.
Yeah.
You know,
I'm not here for this. So.
Next semester. Yeah, he's gone. So
you think he's not here for this?
We're gonna bring him back.
You don't want to get the cart before the horse.
I already passed your class.
You never know what's gonna happen.
But for everyone interested, so freshmen, sophomores, and juniors are welcome to apply next semester. For the organization itself, but additionally, if you're not interested in the organization to actually join, we're actually running a mini course as well. So this is just a 1-credit-hour course. We'll run from October, to pretty much the end of the semester. We're going to teach everything, about fire consulting, of course. We're really focusing on the nonprofit realm, consulting realm itself. So we'll bring in consultants. For instance, we're going to have a speaker, a managing director from Accenture come in and describe, what he does on a day-to-day basis. And so those kind of opportunities are available to anyone that was like welcome to join. So we're opening that application up early in the fall. So, August, September range, if you want to apply. It's not going to be as difficult as getting fire consulting. So definitely if you're interested at all in, consulting or nonprofits or just the organization in general and don't necessarily want to join, the team and do that, definitely take the mini course. I think you'll learn a lot. And maybe you will be convinced to join the actual organization. So 1 week class, 1 credit hour, a lot of great opportunities with that, both professionally and then just learning. So I really think that everyone should look into that, that has gonna be here next semester.
How many of you plan on getting a job when you graduate? Raise your hand if you plan on getting a job. We all plan on getting a job. Some of us aren't planning on getting a job. So imagine you're graduating, you've walked, you're brand new shoes, you're sending out resumes, maybe you're going out and starting up something, but you're sending out resumes. So I'm not an academic by trade. That's not my thing. I'm a business owner. I've been a business owner for about 25 years. Still own a business today. when you send me your resume, I look at it, says University of Dayton. I go, okay, yeah, they went to UD, that's great. You have your GPA on there. I had a 3.something-something GPA. And I go, yeah. And I hate to say this, and I only say this when there aren't other professors in the room. As a business owner, I rarely pay lots of attention to your GPA. You know what I really look at? I look at what you did while you were there. What did you do while you were there? If you just kind of went to school, went to class, and, you know, had fun, yeah, that's okay. Maybe you went to good school, maybe you got good grades. That'll count for something. But I really want to know, what did you do while you were there? What separates you from everybody else? Imagine your resume is sitting in a stack of resumes with P&G, or GE, or Emerson, or any other organization out there. You have to figure out how to separate yourself. And the way you do that is things like this. That's what you talk about when you go into an interview. Those are the experiences that HR professionals, business owners, managers, that's what they're looking for. You know, because then you can say, yeah, I've got a little bit of experience. I've actually been in a room with a client and had to solve a problem for them. You know, I've actually had to improvise at the last minute and carry trays up and down 20 flights of steps or whatever it happened to be in an arena to help a client achieve their goal. You know, that's the difference. Those are the types of things that will help you sell yourself when you get out of here and have to try to compete with the rest of the world and compete with all those other folks out there who are going after those jobs. And the other thing that I want to touch on is this thing about passion. And you know, Steve Jobs would always say that if you're going to get into something, and I would say not just a startup, which is, you know, kind of an area where I spend a lot of time, but what, no matter what it is, whether it's an organization on campus like Flyer Consulting or Flyer Enterprises or Flyer Angels or any of those types of organizations, Hanley or Davis, or whether you're going to get into a job or whether you're going to get into a startup or a nonprofit, that passion is the key. Because you see, the thing is, if we're not passionate about it, if we don't really care about it, then what's going to happen? We're going to quit. We're going to quit because we're sane, right? We don't want to do something every day that we're not happy about, or that we're not enthusiastic about. So when you're out there looking, that's one thing to think about. That's what I like about FC. That's why I'm so engaged in it, is because of that passion that these folks have, or these students have. And I don't really want to call them students, because I don't think that's fair. But this passion that they have for helping local nonprofits and driving the mission forward.
Thank
that's
you. Thank you.
I can go on longer. Any day.
That's not a competition. So, without going any further, we'd like to open up for any questions you have right now.
I don't have a question so much as an acknowledgement, because I do represent a nonprofit that you reached out to. I also teach here in the physical therapy program, and I'm on the board of directors for an organization called the Therapeutic Riding Institute here in Dayton. And what we do is provide horseback riding for individuals, mostly kids, with developmental disabilities. And Brandon was kind enough, through your organization, to reach out and help. So thank you for that. And maybe you could talk about getting your picture taken with a horse.
That was pretty good. That was pretty good. Other clients got, I think, that, see, that, that's, I think that's a testament. So I do get to talk a little bit longer, but this is the truth. This is the truth. This is the absolute truth, right? So someone right here, luckily, I was very lucky to know through my roommate's mom, right? This is my roommate's mom here, right? That was able to facilitate us to get a client to solve real problems for them. So every week, I sit in on a team lead meeting, more often than every week. We meet more often than that for fun, right? For fun. But every week, for formality, we meet and we talk about the problems that we can solve for that nonprofit, right? So I was there in the barn, right? And they're talking to me, right? I'm listening to Christine Perot, someone who's in a leadership position there, able to affect change. I'm in the room with her, we're walking through the barn, I'm looking at these horses, you know, I'm smelling manure in the air, like it's all these things, right? I'm in my suit, I'm holding up, like my portfolio stuff we're doing. I have my team lead sitting down with her. We're talking through what she does. We're talking through what this nonprofit does. She's telling us stories about what they're doing. tell us about the event that's coming up. What can we make it better? What do you think? They ask us, what do you think? What do you think? What should we do this? What are other nonprofits doing? And we can give feedback. We can. And we can make a change. And we can tell Christine that this is something we've seen before. We've seen this happen, you know, with another nonprofit we work for. So just watch out for this. Or add this in there. Or let us help you with something that's really bothering you that you don't have time for, like the social media campaign. Let us set it up on Hootsuite to automate it for you. How much time does that tie up for you? She tells me she wants to have more people riding horses. She wants to work on that. But she has to worry about social media. She has to worry about event planning. Well, let us take that off your plate. Let us take it off your plate. So when we sit at our when we're at home and I'm in, you know, in Stone Mill or someone's in Marycrest or wherever you're at, and you pull up Facebook and you see TRI come up and they have a little promo video of them helping another kid, that's when it comes full circle, right? That testimonial that Steven read to you, that's when it comes full circle. That's like why my roommates are here, or why my friends are here, right? Why this organization's here, why other people I think are here other than just extra credit, is because it's just that. It's that. We are really making a difference for everything that you want to do in terms of career trajectory. I'm not doing consulting. I'm doing investments. But that doesn't really matter, right? It doesn't really matter because what we're doing is affecting a different type of change. You know, I will work on that. I will do that. That's what I'm doing once I leave here. But here, I made a serious difference impacting this community and utilizing what I've learned. And just to go off what Vince said, I mean, I sat in interviews all this year, right? My whole senior year, and you get asked star questions, and you guys will learn what those are, situation, task. You tell a story. I love telling stories, so I'm lucky with those, right? But they asked me 5 story questions about how many stories does a guy have, right? Like 5 in a row of giving different situations of stuff that I've experienced, that I've been through, that I've dealt with. And instead of having to search and dig and look for all these different things, and I say quality over quantity, and I think Molly talked about this, with organizations, we have people that are very great applicants that have a resume that sometimes are longer than 1 page, right? But not because they got double spacing, but because they're in 100,000 things here. And I'm just like, that's crazy. Like, hat off to you. Like, that's incredible. But when you ask them about what they did in each one, it's kind of like, I'll read you the job description. Just read you the job description about what I do, because there's not an opportunity for me to do a lot, because once I get out of, you know, my senior design meeting, I got to go to another engineering, you know, fraternity that I'm in, or this thing. And there's just so much that you don't have the opportunity to just dive and get some depth in something. You know, for these 5 interview questions I was asked back to back, which is like a nightmare. It's like the worst triple threat interview you could have. I use Fire Consulting for everyone. I don't know if that's a bad thing. You're supposed to keep talking the same thing, but I got the job. The reason why I got the job is because I was smooth. I was riding through these. These were easy. We do so much, so many different things. You never know what's going to happen. You never know what a nonprofit's going to need help with, what a friend's going to need help with, what a consultant's going to need help with. And I think that's pretty much summarizes what we all feel and are constantly trying to portray in our values, mission, and vision. That's why it takes us so long, because there's a lot to be said.
Are there any other questions? Feel free to ask right now. If not, we'll also be sticking around, you know, 5-10 minutes afterwards, you can come on up. So, just any questions right now? All right, so feel free to come up afterwards. We'll be sticking around, talk to us about the organization, the class, whatever it may be. Thank you.